the biggest trend, meaning the most recent, you know, and you can call it hype if you want, you know, we'll see if it actually settles into something permanent, has been social, obviously, and everybody's aware of that. But the interesting thing about social now is that if you look at it from an initial trend, social was, you know, exciting and new, and you had to do it because everyone else was doing it, and so on and so forth. But social is no longer experimental. Social now has to actually provide business value. There has to be an outcome that that's meaningful to a business. What you have to be able to do is see some value for your company from your interactions as a company with your customers in social channels. That's one trend that has to be addressed. The second trend that has to be addressed now, and this is kind of the old new one, or it's the new old one, either way, right? So it's customer experience. Now, what a customer thinks of as experience with a company also involves their ability to control that experience with the company, meaning the customer wants to be able to sculpt it, right? They don't just want to have it. They want to sculpt it. They want it to meet their particular individual standards. Key is it's a personalized experience. And the other key is that the customer has control over it. If you do that and you know that social is channels that you're trying to derive value from and see the value from, you're dealing with the trends you got to deal with immediately. Traditional CRM systems, first of all, started with sales, okay? And they were operationalized versions of sales technology and system. Transaction that the company and the customer had between them was captured in a record that was holy grail at the time, was the so-called 360-degree view of the customer, which simply meant, you know, anyone who needed to see everything the customer was doing and had the right to see it could see it. All right, that's all well and good, but the problem is, again, there's a huge amount of unstructured data, meaning conversations going on out there, that doesn't have a format that fits into a transactional system of record and isn't going to be analyzable by that, so there'll be no insights possible, et cetera, et cetera. There's only so much you can learn from a purchase history, right? You learn a lot more when someone says, oh, I hate that brand. You know, I hate that airline. I hate that thing. I love that hotel. I love that, you know, fashion thing. I love that team. The problem you have there, though, is that it's out in a social network or a community or some place on the social web, which isn't owned by the brand. Consequently, the format and structure of it isn't owned by the brand or shaped by the brand, and yet the brand has to know those things.